resign? Should he resign? Joining me to just...
And if we look back at... Because they've won, what, 6 Super Bowls now?
Mm-hmm.
If you go back and look at the 6 Super Bowl championship teams for the Patriots, I'm guessing that probably 5 of the 6 have completely different coordinating staffs.
Yeah?
You know, because they're always losing coordinators. And here's another one. These are new coordinators. Well, the defensive coordinator is a new coordinator. And the offensive one is the same one they've had for a while. But the defensive guy is a new guy, and he's leaving again. He's going on to greener pastures again. So it's not only – and by the way, and Brady does it with different personnel every time, just about.
Seems that way.
You know, I was thinking to myself yesterday, I actually was talking to a friend of mine about it in the second half of the game. I said, it really is incredible that, you know, Tom Brady hasn't, we talk about how much talent you have around you. And it's not that Edelman isn't talented, because Edelman's one of the best in the game at what he does. But would Julian Edelman be a star on other teams? I don't think he would. Probably. And how many times has he had this star to use? Once. They went undefeated and they lost in the Super Bowl when he had Randy Moss. Outside of that, I mean, no offense to Deion Branch, right?
Mm-hmm.
No offense to Kevin Hogan or Julian Edelman, but you guys aren't stars. And Edelman is only with the Patriots, I feel.
Yeah, you might be right.
And Gronkowski is a tight end, is a little different position. And obviously, Gronk is amazing. Gronk's great. Gronk's all heart, and Gronk is. I kind of hope he does retire. He's the meathead and DB that you actually like. I think because he makes fun of himself. And when he makes fun of himself, you don't have to take him as seriously, because he doesn't take himself seriously, and he's likable. But beyond Gronk on the offensive side, it's not like they've had elite players. You know, Curtis Martin goes down in NFL history as one of the all-time leading rushers, but when you think back of Curtis Martin, I mean, he doesn't bring up images of Barry Sanders and Emmitt Smith or Adrian Peterson. Curtis Martin was just steady. Get you 1,000 yards every year. But he wasn't like a 7-yard per carry guy. It's really, you go back and look at that offense, the offenses they've had and how they've done it, and it's not with flash. This is why the Patriot way is so intriguing and gives every other team hope. What dashes that hope is that you can say that's the blueprint to do things and get guys throughout the entire draft and not have to count on those first round picks or second round picks. But the end game for the Patriots is they've got Bill Belichick, and he's the best coach in the league. He's the smartest coach in the league. He knows exactly what he's doing. And no matter how much people try to replicate it, you can't, because there's only one Bill Belichick. And the other side of that, Tom Brady might be the most cerebral assassin there is when it comes to being a quarterback. Nobody puts in more time in the film room. Nobody puts in more time in the offseason to get himself right. I don't think there's a smarter quarterback that I've seen play football than Tom Brady. You know, all due respect to some of the eggheads out there, and you know, I know Ryan Fitzpatrick went to Harvard and all that, but this guy knows football more than any other player in the league. He comes to the line of scrimmage, he knows exactly what's going to happen. And he doesn't make many mistakes. And if he does, he doesn't get rattled by it. He'll just come back out the next drive and fix it.
Do you remember a couple weeks ago the Patriots beat Kansas City? And
I remember that.
Yeah, and we got on the air on Monday, and we kind of did the same thing. Look at their offensive line. Their offensive line from left to right, 7th-round pick, 3rd-round pick, undrafted free agent, 4th-round pick, 5th-round pick. That's the resources they've used to build an offensive line that at the end of the game yesterday, when they needed to run out the clock, starting inside their own 10-yard line, 9 carries, 72 yards later, they're closing the deal with a field goal. Tom Brady, the greatest quarterback of all time, in the drive that sealed the game, all he did was turn and hand it off. Because that's all they had to do behind a 7th-round pick, a 3rd-round pick, an undrafted free agent, a 4th-round pick, and a 5th-round pick.
And that's going against first round pick.
Is that the Rams defensive line?
I believe that's how that works when you got Donald, Sue, Brockers, and then the guy that they
from Jacksonville. Yeah, I mean you're 100% correct.
I mean I don't know that you're 100% correct.
I think you are.
I like the percentage.
percentage.
This is, I find it fascinating. I find it to be, I mean, it's the brilliance behind them, and in turn, we focus on the draft a lot. And want the guy that we plucked from there to be able to do the same thing. And right now, it's sketchy. Because look at the offensive line of the Lions, right? First round pick, third round pick. Was the first round pick?
There's two first round picks. Glasgow was a third round pick.
Yep.
And
I'd have to look at Wagner and Lang.
Lang and Wagner were the top free agents at their position when they were available.
Yeah, and sunk a lot into the offensive line. And can the Lions turn and hand it off 9 times in a row to go 72 yards to finish a game, a Super Bowl, against a Super Bowl defense? Really good.
They were. Yeah, both defenses were really good. The Rams were the one thing, we're getting kind of all over the place here, but I did like how the officials let them play defensively, both sides. They didn't call any interference calls. There were a couple calls. I don't even think they were questionable, but there were some calls that were that they let go because there was some hand fighting in there. Both teams. There's got to be some contact. As long as it doesn't impede you from catching the football, it's not interference. And I thought they did a great job officiating both sides of the ball with that yesterday. Unfortunately for the Rams, they were done by the end of the game. I think the defense was so damn deflated after that awful interception from Jared Goff that what are we going to do?
You're right, by the way. The entire defensive front for the Rams, first-round picks. And there you go. They're shoving it down their throat to put away the Super Bowl. It's Carson Anderson. We'll get to your open line calls. I'll tell the gash story. I got the gash on my forehead. Eddie in his truck. 97.1 the ticket.
Want to wipe out the crud? Whether it's the flu, a stomach bug, or runny nose, MedPost Urgent Care is here to help. MedPost is open nights and weekends, and MedPost lets you book your spot online ahead of time. MedPost Urgent Care is a proud partner of Detroit Medical Center. With WOW's super fast internet starting at just $39.99 a month, and paired with their most popular TV package for just $45 more per month, I can